got a lot of downhills on the greens you got to look out for. Yeah, there's a lot of downhills once you hit the green you gotta look out for.
Yeah, well, if I hit 75 yards, I'm just gonna get there. I didn't beat the hell out of it. First one was a good one, the second one I played and hit instead of flying.
Let's see if I can hit anything. That's not far enough. Well, maybe it is.
Yeah, it's not bad. Better than mine. See mine? You're not in the fucking trees. I got these neighbors. This neighbor I have across the street.
Yeah.
Got that Moses Lottie's Oriental. And every time he walks outside, he's one of those people that puts on a mask, you know? For no reason at all. And I look at him, I'm like, seriously, dude? I mean, not even Moses Lottie. He walks outside.
Foot gimmies too, I think. Or maybe, oh no, he changed it to 6. After this hole, I get to go first. I can show you how to beat me.
Thank you.
At least you didn't get minus points. I haven't been able to putt. I've been having really a lot of problems putting lately. All right, let's see. 64, 59 to the collar, and then it's downhill to the pin. So this is a touchy one.
And it's downhill to the...
It's like about a 50... Like a 56 yarder, maybe. Maybe a little shorter than that. Oh, too short. Way short. Wow. That was bad.
That's okay. You might have done this. It's all about me now today.
How bad
I can be.
I'm trying to show you the way so you can beat me. Yeah, that one you got to bounce in the rough. Yeah. Oh. Just one. Five, 6 foot downhill. I hit a, 49, and it rolled past a little bit, didn't get any bite.
Holy fuck, dude.
I crushed one earlier today. It was running hot. It hit the pin, and then went left to the big old hill that was there and then rolled back to 9 feet.
Really?
Yeah. It was awesome. We carried that 69.
Giants Post Game Live brought to you by Toyota. Dating back to last year, the Giants have now lost 8 of their last 9 games to the Cowboys. The most musical last year with John Collins, Stan Hussle, and Christian Yelich. Oh, D. Gordon, those guys this year. Giants Post, Chris O'Brien, the 18 to Flattery. Thomas Reed, Rich Rowling, here you guys just a second. First, the guys who called the game. And guys, I'll give you
hold on.
The impossible question.
That'll work.
Oh,
possibly a little bit of everything. I mean, tonight, Melanson gives up a run, and Dyson gives up a run, and Maranta comes in and he allows a single, which really, you know, wasn't necessarily his fault, but the walk was. So, and again, it's Anderson and Romuto who have done the damage in the series.
Crap.
So
crap.
Power cycle. Fire, get some sticks. Hit the tree on? I don't remember. This might be the one I hit the tree on. I don't know. Go higher this time.
Sorry, dying here.
Out there.
Because kids are being
replaced. Can't par, I gotta birdie all of them, basically.
I know, well, I
challenge tees, but
yeah,
no.
Yeah, you're right. There's a lot of course with challenge tees.
Some of them are kind of wacky, though, you know? Did your aspect ratio change on the projector?
Yeah, Could have. I mean, that looked like it was all two grids. I think, what? I'm going to look at that.
I don't know if that tree's in the way or not. I can't remember.
What is?
I don't know if that tree's in the way or not. We're going to find out.
Yeah. Tell me.
God damn it. Doesn't like reading this club. About 83, huh? Let's see.
What?
I think about 83.
Yep.
Let's see what it works out to.
Jurisdiction over emergency.
Alright, 85. This would help in center by Parker, not Collins. A cutback situation. Downhill off the mound. Is speaking out against this only because he is not running for he's not running for re-election either. About 75, I think. Is not an accessory to the executive branch. And we demean ourselves and our proper constitutional role when we act like we work for the press club. And that we are only here to do his bidding. Especially now. How did it happen? Our next guest, Jason Johnson, is a PhD in political science. 72, isn't enough.
Hit 75.
I thought we agreed upon 75.
You tried, because the club didn't listen to you very well. Damn, the club never listened to you.
That one looks flat. Pitch is right around 67. And allergic reactions. Get up right away if you have swelling of your face, mouth, and tongue, or trouble breathing.
Tell your doctor if your asthma worsens or if you have a parasitic infection. Fasenra is a targeted treatment for
eosinophilic asthma. Ask an asthma specialist about Fasenra.
Is
Damn.
Face to face with Kim Jong-un, the dictator of North Korea. It's clearly historic.
I give the President of the United States a standing ovation. I think it's breathtaking, it's audacious, it's bold. It will be historic.
Commander-in-Chief's leadership is now leading to a major policy
breakthrough.
Joining our special now, Jason Johnson.
Go.
You
know, the Republican branding to Colt 45 has been going for a couple of years now, right? This idea that you can get elected, that you can be empowered, that you can push yourself, not because of some long-existing principle, but just because you have a personality people like. And the Republican Party has been pushing for this for years, right? I mean, look, this goes back to Reagan. You know, there was a cult of Reagan that we were talking about all the way up until Romney. I don't know if you remember this, but a couple years ago, there was actually, like, a bid for some of Reagan's blood. I mean, that's as cult-like as you can get. There were people who worshipped Reagan, but what's been happening with Trump is that there is no policy associated with it. It's just who people think Trump is, and the Republican Party is going to follow him down this path, and it ends up like most cults end up, which is death and destruction to anybody.
The fascinating point that has brought up Bob Corker is this presidential use of tariffs, which is limited to national security. This is clearly a violation of the intent of the law written by Congress. It will be found to be a violation of international trading rules.
And all these shit puts.
America wins its cases in the World Trade Organization. This time it's going to lose, and Trump is finally going to lose. And Bob Corker is stunned that his colleagues in the Congress have surrendered their power over the president over this. And I have to say, this is the thing during the Trump campaign that I never anticipated, that Congress, Republicans in Congress, would not use their powers in relation to the White House.
Yeah, they've become completely supplicant. You know, the tension between the different branches of government is sort of, it's built in, it's baked into the cake, right? Congress doesn't want to have complete fealty to the president. The judiciary wants to remain independent. And that conflict, that sort of team of rival situation that we have between our branches of government is how do we have stopgaps, is how we keep control. And this Congress, under Mitch McConnell and under Paul Ryan, have decided that we don't care. We're going to give up any of our responsibilities. We're not going to do any oversight. Sanctions against Russia, and Donald Trump is going to say, I don't feel like it. We're going to allow this president to make proclamations and make policies one way or another. We're not going to stop him. And look, what frustrates me about this, it's great that Jeff Flake says things. It's great that Bob Corker says things. But they're not really doing anything about it. They're basically firemen standing around with a lamppost next to a fire saying, man, I wish somebody could do something about this. They should be spending every waking moment of their remaining months in Congress saying, I will not vote for this person. I will not allow this person to be approved. I will stop everything that could occur in this Congress until we get some of these amendments passed. And they're not doing that. They're just complaining. That's why a lot of these sort of, you know, virtue signaling by these Republicans, it doesn't
look so much.
Johnson, thank you very much.
Carried at 71.
Thank you. Tonight's last word is next.
Did you see that?
Oh!
Everything you need to go.
Ouch.
That blows.
Expedia. Touch. Show
some. Wow. I'm the only fucking guy who's going to hit a collider on that hole.
I don't know. Everybody was complaining about the colliders on this course, but I didn't hit any. I hit one, actually, on my actual round. But it was a shitty shot.
Hold on.
Ready for the chance of 100% clear skin. Ask your doctor about time.
I'll always be there when she needs me.
Settlement or roof service delay, going to Home Advisor and found the right pro to help. I can read their reviews and check their credentials.
Yeah, the pro is
good.
If it comes up with my mom's home and I'm not available, Home Advisor always is. Go to homeadvisor.com or download the free app.
Oh, that was looking good, too.
For Ukraine. Also reports that witnesses told the paper, quote, I realize that Michael Cohen is a target of special interest.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of the wedgies.
Yeah.
2 to tie my score that I put up in the tournament.
What was that?
I need 1 more 2 to tie my score that from the tournament.
Yeah, don't get a 4, you'll be pissed.
No, I need a 4, not a 2. I mean a 2 total, 2 strokes. Stuff.
Awesome, dude.
I'll talk to you later.
Have a good one, man. Thank you.
Yep. Bye. See ya.